This is how I warp my 24 inch Becca loom. Now this loom does not come with apron rods, so I created them by using strings and a staple gun, and just stapled a couple of loops, one there and one there, and inserted a dowel that I bought at the hardware store for $1.98. The dowel came 48 inches long, and I had them at the hardware store cut it in half exactly for 24 inches, and it worked perfectly on this loom. So that's what I use for warping. And what I did is I placed my cone down here. I have a screwdriver to act as a sort of peg. I shoved some fabric in there that I made to hold the spool or the cone, bring the thread up, and you begin by tying it to the apron rod. And now what you do is you grab the string here and you pull it through one of the slots in the heddle, and I'm going to set my camera up so you can see that. Okay, so we grab the thread from back there, find the slot we want to start with, and just pull it through. Now there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can have a peg across the room, or what I like to do is I like to sit and do this, so I use my Inca loom. I hope you can see it. I use my Inca loom as a kind of warping board, so I can sit and do this, and doesn't take up as much real estate in the house as if I was to have a peg either across the table or across the room somewhere, and I just weave in and out. And I can just sit here and keep warping, get all warped. And now I grab the thread from the apron rod again and just keep doing that. See, there's the thread down there. Comes up. Goes around the apron rod. Through the heddle. And around my warping board. And see if I can't record this. Oops, pardon me. Get a little better shot of the procedure for you. And again, like I said, you could either have a single peg across the room or several feet away, however many yards you need. But I just use my Inca loom as a warping board, or if you have a warping board, just you can just use it the way it is and just clamp it to your desk so it doesn't move around. And as you can see, I grabbed the thread through there. And I just push these down. Follow the same track that I used to begin with. Saves me a lot of walking back and forth, saves my back and my feet. Now we come under the rod this time. I'll try and get a good picture of this. Now you take it from down here and come up and over so that this gets drawn through the heddle and around the warping board. Hard to film by myself and do this at the same time. Let's see, the next slot would be this one. Because I'm filming the way I am, it's difficult. You just bring this through, pull it, and wrap it around the peg or your warping board, whatever you're using. Oh my god, there we go. Not the world's greatest filming, but, you know, doing it the best I can by myself. And you just keep doing this till you fill it up. as many ends as you need for your project. And next I'll show you how to wind it onto the cloth beam. Or the warp beam, back beam, whatever beam. Beam me up, Scotty. There's no intelligent life down here. Okay, now we can imagine that this is, like, completely warped. I'm just doing a demo example, so I'm only going to do a few threads. So, the next thing I do is take this off of my peg. And here's the thing I do. It's like having an extra set of hands to help keep this kind of taut, and that is to use my claw hammer. I know you're going, what? And I'll try to... I know you think I'm crazy, but this is what I do. I wrap the string around my claw hammer like this. You can see that going around there? What this does is, as I'm rolling the thread onto the back beam, the weight of this hammer will keep the strings nice and even. So it's like having an extra set of hands as if somebody was holding it like this as you were pulling on it. Only the hammer's doing the work. I'll show you that in a second. So now what you do is you remove it from your peg or your warping board and have it go over there on the floor someplace away from you with the thread looped like that, kind of around the T, sort of. I think you get the idea. And you just start winding it on. Now, of course, you would normally be using paper. Oops, I think I rolled it the wrong way. Yeah, I did. Anyway, here we go. This is rolling. And this is getting dragged closer as I pull it. You get the idea? See how it's keeping it nice and even? Just keep rolling. Even as it comes up towards the cloth beam, just go kind of slow so it doesn't pop off. Lifting it. Try to get a better shot. And just keep rolling it up. Keep rolling. Till you get to about here. Then gently lift it over. And have it hang down there. Now you want to do this gently. You don't want it to jerk because it might pull the heddle off of the blocks with the clamps. Just keep rolling it till it's about like that, and then you can start warping the rest. Lock it with the ratchet so it doesn't go anywhere. Then you can remove your hammer and cut those ends with your scissors. Oops. Ends are cut, and then you can start moving one of the slots over to each hole, and, you know, and continue warping the, as you normally would. But that's how I use a hammer and a continuous warp.